you all, but it's not that necessary. I'm so grateful to see you here. That in and of itself really is quite enough. The fact that you would be all united at one purpose for this one thing is quite important. I have to say this. I am a Christian. I am a product of the redemption of Christ Jesus. I need to tell you that. I'm not ashamed of it. It's not old-fashioned. It's what's new and vibrant in my life. So I want you to know that. So, and the other thing I want to tell you is that everything else that I'm about to tell you is because of God's glory, all right? It's not because of anything that I've done. It's because of God's glory. So for me, I believe, let me tell you this also, in the Black Panther Party, we failed because we took God out. I beg you not to do the same thing. If you take God out, precious babies, you're not going anywhere except to jail. You're gonna be killed and you're gonna stay angry, all right? So Lord, thank you for your forgiveness. Thank you for giving me for all of my sins. I have stood on stages in America and I have asked young people if they didn't want their parents didn't like the Black Panther Party, kill your mom and your daddy. Let me tell you that. God has forgiven me, okay? So I don't play around with any of this. To see you all organized is a great thing, but I've seen many organizations and many mass movements. It has to be something else besides what I'm against. I've heard a lot of what I'm against. I don't like this and I don't like that and I hate this. But my God, what are you for? What are you for? What are you individually? I'm not talking about the group. I'm not talking about your organization. Oh no, I am living witness. You must make these decisions. And when you make them, hear me now, be prepared for the consequence. Not your sister, you, okay? Or don't make them. I'm not that impressed till I see the work, all right? I want to tell you something. When I was in both the Black Panther Party and I was in the R&A, I've been in everything, been every religion that black people have been in their sojourn from Africa. I have been every single one of them. When I was in the Black Panther Party, we said we wanted 40 acres and a mule. How many people you know with 40 acres and a mule? I just want to say it because I want you to ask somebody that you know, where is your land? I'm talking about the ones that's got $2 or $3. They got some money. Don't act like all of us is poor. Where is that 40 acres? If you want that, you gotta show that to me by not somebody else's actions, by whose actions? Yours. How committed are you to the dream? And what is that dream you're committed to? How many people are in this place? I'll just say I don't count well, so don't worry about them, get it wrong. I'll say 1,500, that's wrong, I know. But if it's 1,500 people in here, there are 1,500 dreams. You all need to know that. As you mass together and think that everyone is doing it for the same reason, I don't believe so. I could tell you that that is not so. Require something from people. Require something from your leaders. Require morals and ethics. Make it a requirement. Because if you're gonna follow somebody somewhere, you ought to know is somebody of substance, shouldn't you? Because that's what we've done, you know that. We pretending we didn't because today is King's Day. So we're going to pretend that we ain't been following a lot of people that have not had our interest at heart. We're going to pretend that we haven't done that. It's all right to pretend sometime. But take 5 minutes out and tell the truth to you. Tell you the truth. Because then we can get someplace. You understand? That is more important than anything. Okay. I always also want to, I'm going to be finishing a minute because I ain't got nothing but a bunch of things to say. Okay? Just a bunch of things to say. April 4th, 1968, Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King was murdered in this place. that started something in this country. April 2nd, 1969, 363 days later, 21 Black Panthers were arrested in New York City. 1 year later. So the other day, I just celebrated 39 years of my arrest. And where did I celebrate it at? Virginia Tech. Virginia Tech. Yes! There's so much healing to be done in our places. And I don't know whose community we mean when we say our, but for me, our is the world. I don't do things on color no more. I don't do them on color no more. And I tell you why I don't. I just told you, you got to stand for something. When I was in the Black Panther Party, Rwanda had not happened. It had not happened. So I was still believing, like most used to be Pan-Africanists, that my God, the joy is for us to all unite as Africans. We can unite Africa and we can do something great because it's a great, massive continent and we are great people and we are good people and mothers and kings and queens. And my God, look at what the kings did. Are we going to look? If we don't look today, we're going to have to look again tomorrow. And where are the women? Don't play with me. Don't play with me. Where are the women? Where are your stories? You all tell those stories. Find them stories and tell them. They don't have to be cute. If you don't do it, we will be erased. Already these young people don't know that we stood mighty. They already don't know that if it hadn't been for the women, it wouldn't have been no Black Panther Party. They already don't know that. They already think that men did it. They already believe it. You gotta put an end to the lie. And if you don't do that, we can't move forward in anything. So that's all I'm doing, is trying to share with you what I've learned over my life. Over my life. I want to share with you that in Lumberton, North Carolina, where not only was I born, but my mother was born. My grandmother was born. My great-grandmother was born. And my great-great-grandmother was born. In the county of Robeson, we have 56 acres of land. We have 17 acres of organic land. And we are selling crops organically. We have cows and we have chickens. Because I was serious about mine. And if you're serious about it, that's what you'll do. So I'm not saying that to brag. No, I'm saying that because if you don't have the 56, if you don't have the 17, I need you to get down with us. You talking about you got some organ that won't do something? You ought to be doing something connected to some land. It ain't can't be no idea by itself, preciouses. Don't it? You know it. I come from the South Bronx, baby. I organize tennis there. I know about this. We got to have land. We got to have ground. And we can't just have jobs. What else must we have? Can we please, please beg y'all, when y'all talking about all them jobs, I'm not interested in them. I don't care if you don't get a 10. You know what I want you to get? I want you to get some executive courses. I want you to teach my people how to run businesses. Because let me tell you what I know. You don't have to have a degree to run a business. Oh, no, you don't. I am a high school dropout. I'm not bragging about it. But I want you to know this. There is no reason why we got to be talking all the time about jobs instead of about companies. Why not? Can we please dream big? We were doing jobs back then. Let's dream big. That's all I'm asking you.